Hosanna, and good morning. Hope everyone has their palms. If you're at home, hopefully you're able to either pick one up or have some sort of foliage at home you're able to cut or take a napkin and wave it as we celebrate the Lord's triumphant entry into Jerusalem. And this morning, as we continue our series, Rend Your Hearts, Claiming the Promise, we're looking at the promise of the one who comes in Psalm 118. And how he comes in a different way than we expect, and how we can use that in this world today in times that might be less than ideal. So that's what we're looking at today at Palm Sunday. So blessings with you here. So glad you can be with us in person. Also for those watching online, just tell each other good morning. Type Hosanna into the chat box as you're watching along, and share any prayer requests you have. You can start typing those in now or throughout the course of service. So wanted to share that. Also wanted to share as we enter into this Holy Week that, of course, we have our services coming up for Holy Week, and next week is Easter, and we get to celebrate Living the Resurrection. That's the name of the next series we're doing that starts on Easter, and you get to see some preview for it here. And we have services at 8 and 10:30 a.m., our standard service time, so make sure to let us know which of those services you're going to be at, just so we have an accurate count for bulletins and just spacing for seats and whatnot. And it's really cool. If you look down in the corner, you might not be able to see it super well, but there's a butterfly that Rachel made for the series, so you'll see that pop up. It's sort of a take on our logo, a little 3D version, so cool she's able to do that. So I want to thank her for her good gifts, and we get to celebrate Easter next week, so come join us at 8 or 10:30, like I mentioned. Also wanted to mention before that, we have a Holy Week service that we're going to be having this coming Friday on Good Friday, and we're going to have liturgy from both Maundy Thursday and Good Friday occurring during it, but it's mostly a tenebrae service where the lights will go down and candles be extinguished. So join us at 7 p.m. for that this coming Friday, either in person by reserving or online. We'll be streaming that as well. So look forward to you joining us for that, whatever way you can. Also wanted to remind everyone that next quarter's portals of prayer are available. So please stop by and pick those up if you'd like that, or you can email or call, and we can work on scheduling a delivery system. I'm actually scheduled on Tuesday to deliver to Pastor and Kathy Gerken. So if you need one maybe on Tuesday, I'll be doing rounds with the portals of prayer. So wanted to mention that. Also wanted to mention, remind everyone, for the next 2 weeks, we'll be taking a break from our Zoom Bible study during Holy Week as we focus more on that. And then the week after, just to recharge our batteries. So wanted to remind everyone of that. And then when we do start back up, it'll be on April 14th at 7 p.m., we're going to be suspending our 10 a.m. for now, but if there's enough interest maybe over the summer once again to start that back up, please let me know if you're interested again, and we'll sort of schedule that as needed or as interest grows. Wanted to share that. Also wanted to continue to remind everyone of our opening hands opportunities as we are still in hard times for a lot of people, and we can share God's love with them. Big need right now is still food for so many people, so we're still collecting for the food bank, whether it's bags, or you can see some of the options in the bulletin, whether it be things like soup or pasta, or even non-food items like toilet paper, which we know was a big thing last year, or pet food even, something we don't think about. There's people who need help with that, so wanted to share that. And then finally, we're wrapping up the cardstock drive over this Holy Week. So if you want to grab some cards and have them back by Easter, I talked to Inga, and we're going to deliver the ones that are written for sort of an Easter lift me up right afterwards. Or if you can give blank cards, we're going to be giving those to Joan Thomas to hand out at Solstice so people can write words of encouragement to their loved ones. So wanted to remind everyone that that's wrapping up. So with that said, we get to rise and stand. Whether we're here or at home, we can do it as well, as we have a call to worship to enter in to worship this morning, just as our Savior entered in. And so let us give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. God's steadfast love endures forever. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. The Lord is our God and has given us light. Great is our God. Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna. We rejoice because God's steadfast love endures forever. Enduring in him and his love, we worship this morning in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Hosanna. Amen. And let us now sing out, all glory, laud, and honor. King is coming. Our God arrives clothed in frail human flesh, riding a meek donkey's foal. This is not the first time you have come to us, O God. The history of human affairs is the history of your arrival among us as creator, purpose giver, liberator, prophet's voice, and priest's desire. The story of each of our lives is a story of your coming to us as comforter, friend, example, challenger, abundant life provider. And so we praise you. Open our eyes to your presence, O Lord. Come to us again, Lord. Hosanna, save us again, Lord, and be glorified among us, for you are our God. Amen. There are times, though, that the Lord does not come among us because we fall into sin, and for those times, we have to cry out, save us again, and so we do that now as we confess. Patient God, we confess that we love a parade. We are very happy to see banners waving and hear people shouting their praises. Our hearts thrill to see this, but we fail to see the sadness on the face of the Savior. Our shots back out his sorrow. He comes to us as King, and we expect that royal treatment will follow. We do not and cannot believe that in a few days we will be among those who will turn our backs and run from his presence. How fickle we are, O Lord. Yet you continually forgive us and call us to turn our lives around, to see the needs of others, to reach out in trust and faith, to be willing to witness to your good news of saving love. Heal our hearts and give us courage for the days ahead. For we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. So take a few moments of silence to just give over to the Lord those places where you have been fickle in following him. The good news is that, laying aside judgment, God offers us redemption. Setting aside anger, God embraces us with love. Letting go of grief, God pours living water upon us. This is the good news, my friends. Steadfast love and forgiveness endures forever in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed is the one who brings us the kingdom of God. Amen. And now as we continue with our Palm Sunday worship, you may be seated as we hear God's word for us today.
Our reading this morning is from Psalm 118, verses 1 and 2, and verses 19 through 29. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let Israel say, his love endures forever. Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord through which the righteous may enter. I will give you thanks, for you answered me. You have become my salvation. The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. The Lord has done it this very day. Let us rejoice today and be glad. Lord, save us. Lord, grant us success. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. From the house of the Lord, we bless you. The Lord is God, and he made his light shine upon us. With boughs in hand, join in the festival procession up to the horn of the altar. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, and I will exalt you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel reading. Today's gospel reading is from the book of Mark, chapter 11, verses 1 through 11. As they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethphage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and just as you enter it, you will find a colt tied there, which no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you doing this?' say, 'The Lord needs it, and we'll send it back here shortly.'" They went out and found a colt outside in the street, tied at the doorway. As they untied it, some people standing there asked, "What are you doing untying that colt?" They answered as Jesus had told them to, and the people let them go. When they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks over it, he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, while others spread branches they had cut in the fields. Those who went ahead and those who followed shouted, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Jesus entered Jerusalem and went into the temple courts. He looked around at everything, but since it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. And I thought to switch things up a little bit, instead of just doing the Apostles' Creed, that with it being Palm Sunday, we should give our allegiance to the Lord this Holy Week. And so that's what we have here is a Palm Sunday call to allegiance, which we will state together right now. And so let's do that. Lord Jesus Christ, whose greatest moments of triumph happen on the back of a donkey's foal and nailed to a bloody cross, we gather to prepare the way for you in our lives and in our world. There are so many people and things that call for our allegiance, so many kings seeking to rule over us, but you ride into our experience as another kind of king, a serving, humble, and challenging king who calls us not to slavery, but friendship. There are so many things that seek our energy and resources for their own sakes. So many kingdoms seeking our souls for their own glory. But you ride into our experience, heralding another kind of kingdom. A kingdom where the least are the greatest, where the meek inherit the earth, and where children are the best example of citizenship. A kingdom which seeks to bring life, not drain it. There are so many things that draw our attention, so many realities that seek our faith and assent, but you ride into our experience, revealing another kind of reality, a reality where death does not have the last word, a reality where pride, selfishness, and evil are defeated by love and self-giving, a reality which does not parade itself for all to see, but fills every moment, every situation, and everything with life, while waiting for us to discover it. And so we cry from our hearts, "Hosanna, save us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Amen." And with this professed and proclaimed, you may be seated as we continue to sing out, "Hosanna, loud Hosanna." Let's make that our prayer. Lord, as we shout Hosanna, may your presence be what we eternally rejoice in. May it bring us bliss amid all the chaos surrounding our world. May you still our hearts, our minds, and souls as we focus on you and you alone in this service. And Lord, we just ask that you bless the words of my mouth and meditations of our hearts, that they be pleasing to you and you alone. We just ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, if you were here last week, we began by talking about the game, Name That Tune, and how there's melodies that are ingrained in our hearts. And we started there to talk about how there's beautiful melodies of the theme of the gospel throughout scripture that are written on our hearts. I mentioned how with a few words, God's hope can come flooding in like a crescendo of awe and wonder. And I use Psalm 23 as an example of that, how we can hear those words, "The Lord is my shepherd." And from there, we are taking on a journey as we go past the green pastures, the still waters, even through the valley of the shadow of death. And our loving shepherd will still be there with us. And with him, we do not have to fear any evil. I mention this because, as we know, Psalm 23 isn't the only psalm that gives us messages of hope. While Psalm 23 might be the most popular, there are so many psalms that can comfort us through all walks of life. For example, another powerful, well-known psalm is that of Psalm 121, where we hear the words, "I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth." We also have Psalm 46, which was inspiration for Luther's hymn, "A Mighty Fortress Is Our God." And in it we read, "God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear." We even have Psalm 91, which many of you might know as the soldier's psalm, because it gives reminders of God's protection through the battles. And in it, it says, "I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart." These are all powerful, hope-filled words. But did you know that none of these are the psalm that is most quoted in the New Testament? Do you know what that psalm is, though? It's what Susie read, Psalm 118. That is the most quoted psalm in the New Testament. And that's the reason why we're using it today as we parade to the end of our series, Rend Your Hearts, on this Palm Sunday, because it's quoted in our gospel lesson as well. And while Luther used Psalm 46 for the inspiration for "A Mighty Fortress," do you know what his favorite psalm was? Psalm 118. And this is what he had to say about it. "This is the psalm that I love, for it has often served me well and has helped me out of grave troubles. When neither emperor or kings, wise men, clever men, or saints could have helped me." So this is what he went to. This is what we can go to. In any grave trouble we face, go to the words of Psalm 118. And we can be reminded of the one who comes, the Messiah who will save us from all troubles. Thinking about Psalm 118 being the most quoted psalm in the New Testament, we see that it's from Psalm 118 that we see that phrase, "Lord, save us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." This is the same powerful words that the people proclaim as they're waving their palms, as they're letting Jesus enter in victory. They cry out, "Lord, save us," which Mark translates as "Hosanna, Hosanna," Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And it's also from Psalm 118 that a bit earlier in Mark, Jesus points out his role and who he is, that even in the midst of the triumphant entry, he is still the cornerstone that the builders will reject. And so we have a reminder of who he truly is, even in the midst of all the fanfare, that he is the one who comes, but not in the way the people expected or wanted him to. Jesus himself, like a rejected cornerstone, was not much to look at, was he? I mean, just think about his interactions in his ministry. Even when he had been doing ministry for a while, even John the Baptist started to have doubts. And so he dispatched disciples to ask Jesus, are you really the one, or should we expect someone else? They had different expectations. They even said it. You know, someone better, someone more outwardly impressive. And it went that way for most of the time with Jesus, didn't it? If we rewind back to Christmas, he was just a baby born in a manger whose parents didn't have anything better to afford. They couldn't even find a room in an inn because they were all full. And for most of his life, he was just a carpenter's son doing his family trade for most of his life. Pretty unassuming, right? And then even in his ministry, he was this odd rabbi who shared these interesting stories that were hard to make out. And so people wondered, who is this guy? And then, as we will see later on in our Holy Week journey, as he stood before Pontius Pilate, even Pilate, for the life of him, could not figure out why everyone saw this guy as such a threat. You're worried about this fellow? Really? Come on. What are you thinking? Pilate all but asked the Jewish authorities to move Jesus aside. And then finally, though, in the midst of all that, as we will come to on Good Fridays, he's literally crossed out by the Romans. There he was, hanging on a cross, looking more like a street accident than a savior. Talk about rejected stones. Jesus was indeed tossed aside, spurned, rejected, and killed. We'll talk about that more later, but we too struggle with who Jesus is at times, don't we? We want that strong, decisive leader who's going to come in and take no guff from anyone else and will defeat those who are our enemies decisively. And so we line the streets as the people shouting, Hosanna, save us. And these cries, they identify Jesus with a promised descendant of a king, of King David. So that's promising. The ruler of a kingdom which will last forever. We too are declaring with the Palm Sunday throng that Jesus is the one anointed by the Father to be the Christ, the Savior of the world, and also our personal Savior, and that his kingdom will never end. A Savior of the world, though, that sounds like it should be impressive. And yet, his kingdom was not to be established through military might. His entry came as he was seated on a humble colt, keeping in the biblical tradition of one of royalty coming in peace and humility. And in Jesus' earthly poverty, he still needed a borrowed animal to ride in on. And just a week later, he would experience the greatest poverty of his father himself forsaking him as his very life was surrendered to another crowd, a crowd that we too become a part of, shouting, crucify him, crucify him. Jesus' Palm Sunday journey was ultimately one to the cross to take our place. He's the one who comes for us. The Father punished our sin through his Son so that our penalty would be paid for. Jesus gave up his body and shed his blood so that we could be declared forgiven and right with God through faith in Christ the crucified. This is the way he comes to bring victory. Yet even in humility, he is the one who comes. And we see this as the psalmist continues in verse 23. If you go back to Psalm 118, it says, "The Lord has done this, and it's marvelous. It's marvelous in our eyes." It might not look marvelous, though, but it is. That rejected cornerstone, that doesn't look marvelous. And yet the stray stone in the verse about it becomes the perfect emblem about how God achieves salvation, how he works through the crucified and rejected one. And this is good news because the larger context of Psalm 118 is all about being rescued from death. This is all about God's way of destroying death to do something new, something previously unheard of, and just something that was marvelous in our eyes. As we've looked back over the past year, though, it hasn't felt very marvelous in our eyes, has it? A year later, and while we're moving in a good direction, there's still the pandemic ongoing, and it makes our Easter plan still less than ideal, even though we should be able to meet in person. And I'm sure we've all had times over the past year to varying degrees where we have felt rejected, dejected, like that cornerstone the builders rejected. We feel dejected, tossed away, far away from the people that we want to see most and embrace, or tossed away from our grounding, our footholds in life. Can any good come from this? We have been asking. And if we read through Psalm 118, the message would seem to be yes. Not easily, though, mind you. It's not just read it and everything gets better. There are no neat and tidy answers to any of our harder questions right now. But we served and we continue to serve a God who achieved the salvation of the cosmos by taking note of and then restoring to glory and honor a decidedly rejected stone. And do you know what that means? That this Savior, this very cornerstone that is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty, is really adept at seeing us in our isolation right now, because he too was isolated and rejected, but he enters into ours. He reminds us that we are not alone, and that Jesus, the Messiah, is really good at promising, not just promising things, but promising life. We can celebrate and claim the promise of Hosanna because life in Christ has the last word. Life in Christ has the last word. Not the pandemic, not even sin or death. Jesus Christ, the one who comes, has the last word forever. Amen. And it is marvelous in our eyes. And because it is marvelous in our eyes, we praise him. We lift our palms. We praise Jesus with our words. But we can also be like those in our text that praise Jesus by doing. We can be like the man who loans his colt out for the Lord who needs it. We can be like those who lay down our cloaks to line the streets. We can use what we own and add our voice and words as we thank God, our Savior. When we use what we own to be a blessing to others, we end up praising the Lord because God also loves those others who have needs and wants that we can help fulfill. Amen. And we can, even if we don't have a lot, we can use our smiles, our kind words, our politeness, with gentleness and respect, our deeds of love to praise God by serving him and others. We praise him for what he did for us. And while we see his praises and shouts of joy coming to fruition, we know that this will change throughout the course of Holy Week. Holy Week, it swings from one extreme to another, doesn't it? From jubilation of the coming King Jesus to agony, suffering, and his brutal death on the cross, which we grieve. Palm Sunday is indeed celebrated in the shadow of the cross. Holy Week begins on a mountain, Jesus coming to Jerusalem and the temple. And where also does it end? On a mountain, on the cross at Golgotha. Holy Week begins with Jesus riding a colt never ridden before and ends with Jesus laying in a tomb that was never laid in before. But the one who comes does not stop there. He is risen indeed. He will rise and will raise us as well. And this will be marvelous in our eyes, not just now, but for eternity. We will no longer be rejected, but we will all wave palm branches once again. And not just us, but all our loved ones who have passed before us in the Lord, as we read in Revelation 7. After this, I looked, and there was before me a great multitude that no one could count from every nation, tribe, people, and language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. And they cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever. Amen." As we shout out Hosanna to the one who comes, may this forever be our favorite image to share. May this reflect the joy of Luther's favorite psalm, Psalm 118. May we celebrate and claim the promise today and every day that the Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. It's marvelous because of what the Psalm 118, go back and read it, and you'll see that it's bookend on either side, beginning and end, Alpha and Omega. And this is what it says, and this is what we'll go forth to do this week. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. So let us go out to shout out the melody and Hosanna of the one who comes. And let us pray. Hosanna to you, our cornerstone. Thank you for your enduring love that holds us, claims us, and is present with us when we feel rejected and dejected. As we dwell in your enduring, steadfast love, may we be comforted and strengthened in you this Holy Week to share our Hosanna cries with others who need saving and enduring love. In our Messiah, the one who comes, name we pray. And all God's people said, Amen. Amen. And now we'll take some time to have some instrumental music to reflect upon what we've just heard. And you can take some time, if you're at home, to maybe open up your Bible and read parts of Psalm 118 as you listen to the music. Also, you can continue to type in your prayer requests if you have those. And just one last reminder, continued thanks for all the support you give to us as a church, and your prayers, your tithes, offerings, your talents. And so just thank you so much for all those. And God's blessings to you on this Holy Week. And once again, we look forward to you joining us on Friday. So with that said, let's take some time to dwell in the peace of the Lord. And once the instrumental music is done, we'll stand up and shout out Hosanna as we praise the Lord in song. God's blessings.
Let's praise the Lord.
And stand.
We thank you, Lord, that we can find strength in you. Help us to relive that triumphant entry into our lives. Sing and shout, Hosanna to you in the highest. Lord, you truly are the King of glory. So again, Hosanna to you in the highest.
Mm-hmm. I see the King of Glory coming on the clouds with fire. The whole earth shakes, the whole earth shakes. I see His love and mercy washing over all our sins. The people sing, the people sing. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. I see a generation rising up to take their place. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Yes, we do cry out, Hosanna in the highest, Lord. We come to you now in a time of prayer, praying, save us, Lord, so you can go into whatever posture prayer is best for you as we pray. Like I've mentioned before a couple times, if you're online and want to type out a prayer, you can do that as well now. And so let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, and all people according to their needs. And we praise you, O Lord, for coming into our lives as a humble king this Palm Sunday. As we shout Hosanna, may we continually look to you for our saving and hope this holy week and all our weeks to come. May we share our Hosannas out into a world that needs saving and hope once again. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray, O Lord, that you would give pastors, wives, and spouses your strength, your care, and your joy in all they do. May all their churches support and uplift them in all that is going on in their personal journeys and their families' lives. Bless and keep them in your family joy, in your gospel joy. Lord, I especially lift up to you my dear wife, Melina, just ask blessings over her, that you continue to just uplift her and keep her in your love and joy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we give thanks that you accepted the praises of the crowds who worshiped in Jerusalem. And so we ask, Lord, that you would fill this congregation, Resurrection, with such love for you, that we would eagerly worship you, humbly do your will, and lovingly serve our neighbor in your name. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we give thanks for all those who work on assembly lines at all the different factories across our nation and world. Keep their working conditions safe and enjoyable. Bless their families when they work long hours, that they might be able to have restorative time with them, good quality time, and continually give them joy in all they do. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we give thanks. I know it seems like such a small thing to give thanks for, but we give thanks that churches can celebrate Holy Week in person this year. While it might look a bit different still, may we continue to give thanks for the different blessings you give to us, even in these hard times. Keep all who worship in churches this Holy Week safe and joyous, and for those who worship from home, may they continue to just be present with you, knowing that you are wherever the people are. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we're reminded of your presence so often, but there's many who don't feel it. And so, Lord, we pray for those who feel rejected and thrown away by hurtful people and by this world. May you, as the rejected cornerstone, comfort them. And may we be the ones to share your comfort, your cornerstone life with them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And as we think about those needing comfort, Lord, we pray for those who are hurting, wounded so deeply. Dear Father, we present before you those whose families are hurting because they've lost loved ones in the different shootings across our nation. A few more last week, especially the one in Colorado. We ask that you touch their hearts, O Lord, touch their families' hearts. Lord, heal their brokenness and help them not to think and reflect on the violence, but help them turn towards peace in their hearts. So, Heavenly Father, for every shooting victim, we ask that you will bless them and keep them. Make your face shine upon them and be gracious to them. Father, turn your face toward them and give them peace in the midst of turmoil, and bring peace to our land. As we see so much violence, Lord, we pray that your peace would just wash over our nation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we're reminded of that peace as you enter Jerusalem on a donkey and not a war horse. Fill all places of violence with your peace. Protect and bless those who stand in harm's way, our military, our police forces, our first responders, and every day bring them safely home to their loved ones. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And on a larger national scale, Lord, you enter Jerusalem as the Prince of Peace. And so fill the leaders of nations with a hunger for peace, a thirst for justice, and a love for all the people entrusted to their care. Teach them and teach us all to do your will and to long for the day when you will return in glory as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we're reminded that you were greeted with joy as you entered the holy city. And so fill with joy all the hearts of those who suffer, whether it be in mind, body, or spirit. There are many in our presence and many who aren't here today. We know in our hearts who are sick and need healing or restoration of all different kinds are going to be undergoing tests. Lord, we'd ask that you turn their sorrow into joy, their suffering into health, and their cries for help into shouts of praise. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And at this time, now lift up any of the prayers on your hearts or continue to type them out in your homes. Hear our prayer. Hear our prayer. Hear our prayer. Hear our prayer. Hear our prayer.
Lord, I thank you for my sister Mom Kathy and her friendship and strengthen her as she's doing adult care for both her parents and her in-law. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. Lord, as we continue to cry out, Hosanna, save us, we lift up to you all these prayers, spoken and unspoken, and all those lifted up in our homes, any that are typed out, we lift them all up into your hands, Lord. We commend all for whom we pray. Trust in your mercy, and as your children crying out, we are bold to pray as you taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And as you now go to proclaim the Lord who enters into our lives in this place and into this world, as you go forth to shout Hosanna and share the love of the cornerstone, may this cornerstone bless you and keep you. May he make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. And let us now go forth singing Hosanna once again.
Yes, Lord, we do lift up your name. With hearts full of joy and praise, be exalted, O Lord our God. Hosanna to you in the highest.
Hosanna. Be exalted, O Lord, my God, Hosanna in the high.
Amen. As you go forth, go in peace and serve the Lord and shout Hosanna. Amen.
Thanks be to God.